We live in a practical world. We set goals and then go out and achieve them. Why should scientists like me be any different? Why shouldn't we too be motivated by the end results? Let's imagine a world in which all scientists put aside their curiosity and concentrated on practical goals. In short, a world without basic research. Take the internet. When physicist Tim Berners-Lee came up with the World Wide Web, he was actually looking for a tool to help scientists search for matter in the universe. So, in a world without basic research, there would have been no internet or GPS. When they invented the atomic clocks used today in GPS, no one was thinking of how to get around town. They were trying to understand the properties of the atom. And without Einstein's theory of relativity, those precise calculations needed to pinpoint your position would be off. Without basic research, forget about GPS. And while we're at it, forget about popcorn as well. The microwave oven that pops your corn in minutes was invented by Percy Spencer when a chocolate bar in his pocket melted during experiments in radar technology. Inventions like the microwave only happen when there's room in the lab for people to follow their curiosity. No curiosity, no microwave popcorn. The curiosity principle goes for your cell phone, too. Without basic research, we would have no antibiotics, no CT or MRI scans. There would be no pacemakers or stents, no equipment for artificial respiration or resuscitation. Without basic research, some of us wouldn't be here today. Is this really the world we want to live in? At the Weizmann Institute of Science, we allow ourselves to follow our curiosity. But on our way to understanding the world, we sometimes find and invent things that improve the world we live in today. For instance, Professor Nathan Sharon researched certain compounds found in soybeans. His student at the time, now Professor Yair Reisner, gained insights that helped him to develop an advanced method for transplanting bone marrow, used today on many leukemia patients. Professor Israel Dostrovsky looked for a way to separate oxygen isotopes. Today, his method is used to produce heavy oxygen for PET scan technology. Professor Leo Zaks thought of a way to determine the sex of a fetus using a simple test of amniotic fluid. Today, this test is routinely performed for fetal genetics. Other Weizmann inventions include digital encryption, drugs and vaccines, a method for manufacturing polymers, and enhanced visual displays for pilots and surgeons. Actually, without some of these inventions, we wouldn't be able to make this film. Today, at the Weizmann Institute of Science, the journey those scientists began continues, guided by curiosity. Biochemistry professor Dan Taufik researches the evolution of biological molecules inside tiny artificial cells. Mathematician and computer scientist Professor Shafi Goldwasser addresses issues in advanced cryptography. Mathematician and computer scientist Dr. Eran Segal is one of the founders of a new field called biomatics, which uses mathematical tools and new ways to understand living systems. Physics professor Adi Stern researches quantum theory in the context of quantum computation and nano-sized systems. Material scientist and physicist Dr. Roi Bar-Ziv creates man-made environments to control the expression of genes and to explore biological circuits. Immunology professor Edith Shachar studies the mechanisms regulating the differentiation and function of immune cells. And I myself am a physicist trying to understand the basic principles of living organisms. What will come of all this? It's hard to tell. But just as our modern way of life is built on the basic discoveries of yesterday's basic researchers, today's basic research is already creating a better world for our children and our children's children. My friends, without your help, none of it can happen. We need you as partners to strive towards the one goal we all set for ourselves, making the world a better place. So you see, there's really nothing so practical as basic research. Let's get back to basics. It's our ticket forward to the future.